In Blender 4.2, quite a lot of changes have been made to the Eevee render engine, as it's now been added with ray tracing, and it's all in all just a much better quality render engine now. But this has made setting up glass in Blender a little bit different while using Eevee. So today I'm going to be showing you how to do this. So first of all, we're just going to create a very easy glass shader. So I'm going to press Shift A, then under Mesh, I'm just going to choose Cube, and then I'm going to left click my object, so we can add a material to it. One way we could do it is we can come down to this menu here called the Material Properties, and you can see here there's a button called Plus New, which will allow us to create a new material. Another way we can do it is I can come to my timeline here, left click the clock, and change it to the Shader Editor, which is a much more sophisticated menu for editing your materials in Blender, as it allows you to control and view everything as a node, which makes navigating complex materials much easier. I'm going to press Plus New in any of these menus, and you'll see in both of these menus a new material has been made. To make this glass is really simple. We're just going to want to turn this transmission value up to 1 under the transmission parameter in our default principal BSDF. You can of course just use a glass BSDF shader instead. However, I like to use the principal BSDF as it's a much more flexible shader in general. Plus, it saves me having to delete a shader and add a new one. But right now, if I make any changes to my shader, we're not going to be able to see it, and that's because we're not in material preview. So I'm going to come to the top here and change to my viewport shading material preview mode, but you'll see that our object has gone black, and this is what happens in Blender 4.2. But to fix this is quite simple. I'm going to come up to the render properties at the top here, which looks like the back of a camera, and here I'm going to change my render engine to Eevee, since this is a Eevee render engine tutorial, and I'm going to scroll down to this option called ray tracing. Again, since this is Blender 4.2, if you were working in an earlier version, this tutorial isn't really going to apply to you because Eevee is a lot different in these previous versions. You also won't have this ray tracing option in those previous versions. So if you have ray tracing, you are going to be in the right version for this. I'm going to left click the box to enable it, and you're also going to want to make sure your max roughness here is set to 1. If you can't see these options, it's because this menu is closed. You can see when I left click this arrow here, it's going to open and close the ray tracing menu. But yeah, you're just going to want to turn your max roughness to 1. Then, as I mentioned, to create glass, all we need to do is come to my transmission here, and I'm going to change my weight from 0 to 1. You can see we're starting to get a glass material, but it's a little bit unreflective. And to fix that, all we need to do is change our roughness, which is a parameter which controls clarity of reflections. And I'm just going to change it to something really low, like maybe 0.01. And there, we've got some glass, and while this will work fine in cycles, one issue we have in Eevee is when we're working with multiple objects in our scene. So if I press Shift A, for example, and then under Mesh, I choose Cube. If I press G and Y to move my cube behind my glass cube, you can see even though this is a glass material, we can't see our cube through our glass. And in previous versions of Blender, there was a couple settings we needed to check. Thankfully, in Blender 4.2, there's now only one setting we need to check. So I'm going to left click my glass cube, I'm going to left click this material properties menu, and we're going to scroll all the way down until we find this option called settings. Here we can open up this other menu called surface, and you can see there's an option here called render methods, and underneath there's something called ray trace transmission. Notice how the parameter we've just edited is also called transmission, so that will make this setting a little bit easier for you to remember. And we just left click this box to enable it. And you can see we can now see our cube through our glass. Just like in previous Blender versions, glass is never going to be quite as good in Eevee as it is in cycles, but it still looks a lot better than not being able to see through the glass at all. And yeah, that just about covers it. If you want to learn more about the new features in Blender 4.2, I do have a playlist here which you can feel free to check out if you want to learn a little bit more about the new features. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.